Leave me alone, Mr. Adams. You're wasting your time.
As chairman of the war committee, I can state for a fact that the army has never been in better shape. Never have troops been more cheerful. Never have soldiers been more resolute. Never have training and discipline been more spirited. Good.
May we have your ears, gentlemen? Mr. Thompson has a dispatch.
From the commander, Army of the United Colonies in New York, dispatch number 1157 to the Honorable Congress, John Hancock, President. Dear sir, it is with the utmost despair that I must report to you the disorder and confusion that reign in every department.
Ah, sweet Jesus.
The Continental soldier is as nothing ever seen in this or any other century. He is a misfit, ignorant of hygiene, destructive, disorderly, and totally disrespectful of rank. Only this last is understandable, as there is an incredible reek of stupidity amongst the officers. The situation is most desperate at the New Jersey training ground in New Brunswick, where every able-bodied whore in the... in the colonies has assembled. There are constant reports of drunkenness, desertion, foul language, naked bathing in the Raritan River, and an epidemic of the French disease. I have placed this town off limits to all military personnel with the exception of officers. I beseech the Congress to dispatch the War Committee to this place in the hope of restoring some of the order and discipline we need to survive. Your obedient, G. Washington.
That man would depress a hyena.
Well, Mr. Adams, you're a chairman of the War Committee. Do you feel up to whoring, drinking, deserting, and New Brunswick?
There must be some mistake. I have an aunt who lives in New Brunswick.
You must tell her to keep up the good work.
Come, Mr. Adams, you must see that it's hopeless. Let us recall General Washington and disband the Continental Army before we're overwhelmed.
Oh, yes, indeed. The English would like that now, wouldn't they?
Why not ask them yourself? They ought to be here any minute.
And when they hang you, Mr. Adams, I hope you will put in a good word for the rest of us.
Face facts, Mr. Adams. A handful of drunk and disorderly recruits against the entire British Army. The finest musket men on earth. How can we win? How can we even hope to survive?
Answer me straight, Chase. If you thought we could beat the Redcoats, would Maryland say yea to independence?
Well, I suppose...
No supposing. Would you or wouldn't you?
Very well, Mr. Adams. Yes, we would.
Then come with me to New Brunswick and see for yourself.
John, are you mad? It's a sham.
They're pushing you into it, Johnny.
What do you say, Chase?
Go ahead, Sam. It sounds lively as hell up there.
All right. Why not? And maybe it'll be John Adams who comes to his senses.
Mr. President, the War Committee will heed General Washington's request. A party consisting of Mr. Chase, Dr. Franklin, and myself will leave immediately.
Is that satisfactory with you, Dr. Franklin?
Wake up, Franklin! You're going to New Brunswick.
Like hell I am. What for?
The whoring and the drinking.
All right, Chase, move all that lard. Not a moment to lose.
Left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right.
Sit down, gentlemen. The chair rules. It's too damn hot to work. Well, General, what's it like out there?
You probably know more than me.
Sitting here, sweet Jesus, this is the last place to find out what's going on.
I'm aiming to join up.
Oh, what are you talking about? You don't have to join up. You're in Congress.
What's that got to do with it?
Well, you don't see them rushing off to get killed, do you? Sure, great ones for sending others, I can tell you that.
Hey, who sits here?
Caesar Rodney of Delaware. Where are you from, General?
Watertown.
Now, where's that?
Massachusetts.
Well, then you belong over there. Well, but be careful. There's something about that chair that makes a man awful noisy.